Today, we're bringing to you a fantastic culinary concept on molecular deconstruction part of national cuisines, hosted by Alvin and a few very, very talented females hosts. In this series, Alvin actually traveled to 6 different locations accompanied by attractive hosts to experience and deconstruct national cuisines. In the Singapore episode, we have Joanne Pei as the co-host. And then the deconstructed menu consists of no less than your favorite kaya toast, chicken rice, Singapore sling, and chili crabs.
This is my deconstruction of the chili crab, okay? I start with the basic ingredients of chili crab. Now, another thing that's, you know, very, very apparent, but not maybe not noticeable, is egg, okay? Because you always have an egg wash in the sauce, okay? So I made it into souffle. So, you know, egg, first thing came up to me, souffle. So this is a chili crab souffle, okay? So basically, so please eat it as a souffle. Use a spoon if you have in front of you. The inspiration of this dish, everybody think, oh, you know, obviously coconut, and then it's an easy target for ice cream. But the reason I made it into ice cream, what actually attracted me, what I observed, was actually the peanuts and the cambalis, which is the fish. That was really what inspired me to do the ice cream, because, you know, the peanuts and then the sambal and, you know, the red sambal. The comb is in green because, you know, they wrap the nasi lemak, you know, in banana leaf, or they wrap it in a green leaf. All that together inspires me to, you know, to put this into an ice cream cone. So it's just not just coconut. The third thing I think of was a cornet, okay, with a, you know, when I had it as a kid. And this is why I made it into an ice cream. So sometimes, you know, there's little things that, you know, give you inspiration as well. This is soup lung, and it's basically for the experts who had it, it's basically a bone marrow dish where they suck the bone marrow with a straw and a very sweet red sauce. So I decided, well, let's make the whole dish eatable. I wanted to make something that was less messy, and instead of having to dip the bread, the bones that, you know, what in front of you, these bones are completely eatable. They're made with potatoes. Okay, the sauce, I kept the original DNA, which is a very, very red sauce made with ketchup, tomato paste. All that sauce was done with a lot of lamb shank. In the original dish, okay, you were just braising the bones in the sauce, so it wasn't very, very, it didn't have a lot of lamb in that sauce. So this sauce, the only difference is this sauce, because it's made with a lot of lamb shanks, it has a very, very strong flavor of lamb. And also, you know, underneath these bones, you know, with the lamb shank, I made a confit of the lamb shank. You know, a very nice, mushy, soft, so I'm keeping the whole dish soft. These bones are very hard to make. They take about 4 hours from scratch. Also, very important, I kept the bone marrow, so you have bone marrows in the dish. And also, something to cut, which is not found in the dish, I took some laksa leaf, I made it crispy, to give it a texture, and also to cut into the richness, because it's a fairly rich dish, you know, with all the pasta, you know, from the bone, a very rich sauce, and the bone marrow, and the confit of lamb shank. So that will cut into it to balance the dish. Now, we did the soup de loup for some of you who don't know what that is. That's basically beating an egg with tea until it flops, okay? And it's a breakfast dish from Indonesia. So I took a lot of cloves and I infused it into the tea. So when this tea come out in the morning, you can imagine having this in the morning and you smell this clove, it's like smoking in the morning. So in here is just basic tea, sugar, add a little bit of cinnamon for another aroma, and that's it. Now, also, I thought that what if the tea was a bit plain, so if I add something else to spike it up a bit, to make it, you know, to give it a little bit more flavor. And I was thinking, I just thought about today, I don't think it's a good idea for Indonesia, because, you know, them being Muslim is a splash of orange, okay? It goes, you know, orange always goes with the clove. So I took some conjo, okay? And that will just add an extra flavor. And so now, let's take the egg. We're only gonna take the yolk only because they only take the yolk. So what we do is we just take the yolk, okay? So we take, and you know, in Indonesia, what they do is they do, you know, they take a raw yolk and they pour hot tea in it. So I take the tea, and I'm just going to make this mixture of tea and egg yolks. Very simple. So this is tea, egg yolks. That's it. Okay, so that's the mixture. Now, what you do now, or what they do in Indonesia is they will begin to pour hot tea and they flop it up. They start to beat it with whisk until it flops up, you know, into a nice foam, okay? Now, I'm not gonna do that because I'm gonna make this cold. So what I have here is I have some dry ice, okay? Now, I'm gonna pour this on, and sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't work. But what's gonna happen is now going to fluff up. So what better way to make tila tu, make it fluff without having to use, you know, without all the work. So now you eat this, by basically taking a spoon and just, you know, and then it's got a nice flavor because it's got, you know, it's got the egg, the carbon dioxide will make this thing slightly sparkling. So, you know, it's a nice dish. And of course you can see, you know, if you don't stop eating, it will grow on you. So that was what I did with tea tilu. I have here, this is basically all the spices, all the herbs and coconut milk, you know, beef rendang. So if you were to do beef rendang, you would just put the beef in and then cook it for 6 hours, okay? And 6 hours later, you will have a piece of beef, okay, that would keep for a month, okay? It'll probably stay in your stomach for a month. That's how long it's gonna digest it. Now, so I've added, you know, for extra texture, I added some, you know, crispy bean curds, or just, you know, fried bean curd. Okay? Decided, okay, I still want the coconut flavor in, but because the sauce, you don't really get a lot of coconut. So I took some vermicelli, and basically what I did was, if you can look at it, I soaked it, and I braised it in coconut milk, okay? So you can get this nice kind of pasta noodles, gonna fill you, you know, you're just not eating just beef, okay? Because traditionally, they'll probably eat it with rice, okay? So I just took some, and of course, you know, in Indonesia, they also like coconut rice as well, okay? So what I did, let's be different, let's give it a new texture, let's just take some vermicelli, raised, you know, which has been cooked in coconut milk, and, you know, this will give you the starch, this will cut into all that strong flavor of the rendang, okay? So I got my miniature hot pot going. I'll put in my my crispy tofu or bean curd. Okay? And then what I did was I took beautiful wagyu beef and I sliced it paper thin. Okay? Now, instead of having to wake up at 2 in the morning to serve this 6 hours later, I can now wake up, you know, at around 6 hours later, 8 in the morning, okay, and not have to worry that I have dinner on the table, or breakfast on the table. Apparently, you know, this is eaten for breakfast. Has that breakfast on the table, you know, an hour later. Okay, so just gonna take the beef, and this will cook in this broth, just like a hot pot. Those of you going to Hong Kong, they call it hot pot. In Malaysia, I think they call it steamboat. I don't know what they call it in Indonesia. Do they have this in Indonesia? They should, for the beef rendang, okay? Then I'll go there more often. And then we're just gonna just lay that in here. So that all that nice flavor, I'll just give it another piece. So you get all this nice texture, flavors. And of course the meat is now absolutely tender because it's Wagyu beef, it's gonna melt in your mouth. And then you got that coconut, you know, pasta underneath that. Put in a bit of sauce. Okay. And I'm just gonna garnish that with a little bit of parsley, just for a bit of freshness. And there it is, the Mai Extreme Beef Rendang. Thank you.